pop out that chat. Not hosting anyone right now. Should be live, right? Streaming.
No, came to me.
Ah, there we go. It is gone. Perfect. Where'd my chat go? Let me go double check how my stream quality is going. Just checking stream quality. Okay, I guess we'll give it a minute here, see if we can get a couple people in. I'll kind of do a little bit of a clean up, I guess. Let me see here. How can I scroll down? No, go away. Oh, I see. It won't let me do that. Oh, well. What if I do this? And pop that out and kind of drag that up here. Yeah, I think that'll work. Well, I can tell we're going along and now finally live. So let's get this started. Gonna start our oven up here. Got some nice fat organic beets. These things are monsters. Whew. Well, that one's got a little bit of the... Alright, let's see. So we're going to want to get these going pretty fast. They're going to take at least like... Well, based on how fat these things are, they're going to take about 40 minutes or so. Might chop that one in half. And wrap it individually because it's just kind of... really fat. I think that might be a good idea. Let's get a knife out. Actually, it's knife sharpening day. Let's see old knives out, y'all. Get this sucker sharpened. This apparently does something. Seems to help. Can't complain really when it does actually seem to make the knife sharper. Let's give this a good one. Sharp knife is definitely one of the safest things you can get going in a kitchen here. Definitely helps. There we go. Oh, should probably post on some whole social media. Tell people I'm actually around and streaming. That would help. Let's see here. Old Facebook tends to be a good way to do it. We're making roasted beet salad with almonds, bacon, feta and a blood orange vinaigrette. Get out at. Nope, not fucking that ugly old stuff. Don't need no emotes. www.twitch.tv/Artrin1680. Host. Boom. There we go. Did that not, usually it will do the whole little pop-out thing, but maybe it's because it's a full-on one there. Oh, lovely. Tunric and Old Earth, thank you very much for the follows.
You mean auto-host?
Or auto-host. Auto-host it is. I should have sold it, donkey. Okay. That'll get some... Oh, I guess I should pop on Discord as well. Discord helps. I mean, most of these people probably already follow me, you know? You never know. All right. We got some sharp knives. We're going to slice these freaking beets off. So we're just going to basically, we're going to roast these, so... Essentially, we're going to wrap these in tin foil and then just bake them for like 40 minutes till they're pretty soft. So I'm just going to give this a little cut off the top here. Beets are pretty thick, so, you know, be careful. There we go. Trim off all that stuff nice and clean. Give them a really good rinse under some cold water. But you want to leave the skin on these things. Skin on is good. We'll peel it afterwards. It'll be a lot easier to peel. You can pretty much just like roll it off. You can chop off that so it'll sit better on the board. There we go. And if you want, you can reserve the greens. Beet greens are really tasty. I'm not a massive fan of them, but we might give it a try later on. Use that as my organics bin. So after you give these a good rinse, we're simply just going to wrap it in tin foil. It's pretty simple. This is going to take the longest, so that's why I'm starting with this. There we go. Beat number one. Oh, there we go. That's why. On the table, on the board. There we go. All right, so this sucker is huge. So I think we will actually, we'll cut this one in half. Hopefully that will help our cook time on it and make it a little more in line with the rest of the cook times. That way we're not letting the smaller one cook faster than the excessively large one there. So we'll give this one a good rinse as well after we kind of make a flat surface for it to sit on when it's in the pan, because that's helpful. We don't want beets rolling around on the pan. There we go. Some more of this going here. There we go. Make it nice and tight. We're essentially going to roast and/steam these things. The steaming will help cook them faster since they are relatively dense. Oh, I was going to cut that one in half. What am I thinking? I'm clearly not thinking. There we go. These two large ones, I will cut both in half here, I think. Whew. Look at that. These things are just beautiful all the way through. There we go. Now, when you're doing this, you want to make sure that the top where you kind of fold all the tin foil together is up. A lot of beet juice will come out as they cook, and that stuff stains. So you definitely don't want to have that staining the bottom. I am going to line that with some foil as well, but you never know when it's going to leak through or there's going to be a small hole or anything like that. Would never be fun. All right, I'm just gonna give this one another quick cut in half, just so we have three beets that are probably roughly equal in size, basically. There we go. There we go. And then this one will get wrapped. There we go. All right. Like I said, we'll line our pan with a little bit of foil here as well. So we've got our oven preheated to 350. That will cook these beets in about 35 to 40 minutes. So we'll have some time to kill. That's all right. That's why we're doing them first. All right, so we'll set our timer for, we'll set it for 40, but we'll probably check it around 30 to 35. You really just want like a knife to go in really clean with very little effort. Basically, like you do anything. That makes it nice and soft, but it'll keep the beets to have a little bit of firmness and a slight crunch for the salad. All right, so you're gonna wanna clean your cutting board pretty quick. There we go. Like I said, if you want, you can save these beet greens. Just give them a quick little trim. Beet greens are apparently really tasty, so you can save them if you want. If these ones were a little more leafy, maybe I'd peel the leaves off, give them a quick little blanch, and put it in with the salad, but there's not a whole lot of leaf there, so not going to bother with that. Toss that over there, put that off to the side. All right. Now I've got some raw sliced almonds here as well. We'll give these a little quick toast as well to toss in with the salad. But we want those to kind of toast up and then cool down as well. Pretty easy to toast almonds. You could do it on the stovetop if you really want, but I've got an oven going, so why not use it? So I'm just going to line this pan here with that. Kind of spread these on. You want a thin layer. You really don't want any of them overlapping too much. Otherwise, you're not going to get an even browning on them. We're just making this for two, so we don't need a whole lot. Just like that. And we'll just put it in there at 350, just like we have the rest of our stuff in there, the beets. There we go. Those won't take nearly as long, probably like 5-10 minutes tops. But it'll just kind of caramelize them a little bit, brown them up, It'll be a little less raw tasting, and it's good. Okay. So we'll start here with, well, we can get our bacon going, I guess. It's probably best. It's going to take about 10, 15 minutes to cook. Gives it a chance to cool down. Don't know why that's there. All right. So we got our pan. Usually you use a little bit of a higher top or lower top one, but it's whatever. I got some decently thick sliced bacon here. Applewood smoke flavor, you know. Good luck finding good stuff anywhere without paying an arm and a leg for it. Where'd all my scissors go? Ah. Kitchen shears. Always, always helpful. There we go. All right. Let's see here. Oh, this has easy open. Even better. Then I don't have to wash my shears. Or at least it seems like it does. All right. Definitely doesn't. There we go. Now what we'll do is we'll actually chop some of this bacon up. It'll help it cook faster and crisp up a little better along all the edges of the bacon as opposed to just around the edges of the full strip of bacon and not the chunks that we would normally chop it up into. So we'll take about 3 strips of bacon here. We'll want to find some with a decent amount of marbling on the meat, you can see there. The fat here isn't as useful to us since we're going to try and render that off. There we go. So, pretty easy. You know, you can choose whatever size you really want for this. I like about inch thick or inch wide. And then it's got, you know, the quarter inch thick slice. Let's chop that nicely. Go. Nice little bit right there that'll cook through, and that's basically just straight up fat we don't really need. All right, so we'll turn our heat on to like low to medium. It's bacon, so you want to toss that on there while the pan is cold. And then we're going to render this bacon so we can get it nice and crispy, but also help to remove some of the fat. So what we're going to do is once it starts to kind of cook, we're going to add just a little bit of water to the pan, just enough to essentially cover the bacon. That will help it cook a little more evenly. As well, it'll allow the fat to render out of the bacon and allow it to crisp up a little better. Just try and throw all this in here relatively neatly. There we go. Perfect. These little corner pieces here can just hide in there somewhere. Perfect. All right, get rid of that. And since I've only got a couple of cutting boards, I'll clean this one up. Beauty. All right, and this is about the time we whip out a beer. There's the traditional. You want one?
Yes, please.
Come on. Come on out. There we go. Boom. Cheers, people.
There you go.
Thank you.
Okay, it's going along nice. What do we got here? Just me. You should go pop me on. What do we got here? Ah, here we go. Let me go up here. Go here. No, come on. Yeah, there we go. Let's see what we got. Oh, a lot of people cooking tonight. Oh, someone's doing breakfast for dinner. Hawaii cooks. I don't know how that gets so many viewers all the time. Oh well. What we gonna do? Pause. All right. Let's get all this back up here. All right, so we got the bacon starting to go. Let's see if we can't get a good little view of that.
I guess I got it on the worst camera for this, but or on the worst burner.
Oh, well. I really don't want the bacon to splurt up on my keyboard and my laptop, so we're just going to keep it like that. All right, so we're going to get a little bit of water here. Bacon starting to cook, so I'm just gonna add some water, just a little bit, just to help render it out. It'll cause the cooking to take a little bit longer, but like I said, we'll render that fat out, and it'll be delicious. All right, we'll store the rest of our bacon. Where is that? I guess it's probably in use somewhere again. It's alright. It's there. We'll use this.
Oh well.
Alright. Put this into a container. Now, when I'm doing this, I like to. Oh, perfect. I like to kind of pre-break it into chunks. So kind of like usually like three strips will be good for one dinner or like one meal. So I kind of break it into three. That way, you know, I don't have to like pick the whole thing up and later on I can just grab it. Bacon is starting to go. Got some nice heat on that. Put our other bacon away here. At what we got in the fridge. What's in that bowl? Oh, that's bad. Okay. Get that out. We'll need that shortly. I'm gonna take a look here. It's been about 10 minutes on the almonds. They're getting nice and brown here, so I'm just gonna kind of give them a flip. Looking good. Put them back in for a few more minutes. There we go. Let's get this little angle better, I think. Hopefully, I don't kill you guys. Let's get all that crap out of the way. No one wants to see all my stuff there.
There we go. So we got our bacon rendering away here. That will be nice. So we'll start to make the vinaigrette we're going to throw on this. Won't need that right away. All right. Get one of our cutting boards again. Got a nice blood orange here. I guess that kind of sucks. Wish I had a third camera. Oh well. So I got a blood orange. We're gonna juice this sucker. I've actually, it's not worth getting the electric juicer out. I had a good container for this. Oh, excuse me. Must have got rid of it. Oh well. Yeah. Alright. So we'll get our blood orange here. Boom. Oh yeah. Look at that. That is a bloody orange. Wow. Beautiful. Maybe I'll look at the juicer. We do want as much of that as we can get. There we go. Plug that sucker in. This thing's pretty handy. I like it. All right. There you go. Make sure it's nice and clean in there. All right. Then all I gotta do is simply press. Oh yeah. Look at that. Why does that skip so bad? There we go. Oh, I see. There we go. All right. Not the juiciest of oranges I've ever seen. That is for sure. Though, I mean, blood oranges aren't exactly known for being excessively juicy. Still. Oh, well. That just skipped right out of there. Ah, we got plenty of juice down there. Not nearly as much as I would expect, but that's fine. All right, so you can see our bacon is starting to render down quite nicely. Make a giant mess. Now I'm just gonna start to kind of flip it. Let it kind of brown. Ah, smells so good. All right, so like I said, we added a little bit of water into the pan. That helps the bacon render its fat a little nicer. Just kind of cooks it before the fat starts to render out. And that'll allow us to get our bacon a little extra crispy without baking it or anything like that. There we go. All right. It doesn't really work that well. Perfect. Okay. So we're going to move on. Keep on making our keep on making our blood orange vinaigrette. It's pretty simple stuff. Kind of put that off to the side for cleanup later. Get rid of these things. Not bad. Probably not the best blood orange I've ever had, but not too shabby. All right, bacon's starting to get nice in there. So we got that cut up. We got our little dish we'll use here to make it easy for shaking. Got our juice. Give our container a rinse because again, blood orange is similar to similar to beets. That dark red in nature just loves staining everything. We'll also grab some balsamic vinegar. Add a little bit of that in there for flavor. And then we'll get just some regular vinegar. Just a little bit in there as well. And then, of course, it wouldn't be a vinaigrette without a lot of olive oil. So you pretty much want to do like a 1-to-1 olive oil to vinegar ratio, essentially. That way it won't be too thick, but it also won't be too thin. Get a little bit of salt in there. Just a touch of black pepper. And some people would say it's not a vinaigrette if you don't put a little bit of mustard in there. So we can toss a little bit of mustard. So our bacon is getting nice and crispy. And that's what we want. We want to add that nice kind of crispy texture to our salad that we're also going to be achieving from those toasted almonds, which are probably done. Oh yeah, look at that. Beauty. We'll let those sit there and cool down while we get our bacon flipping around here. Let that go. Beautiful, beautiful bacon. All right. Put that in. I mean, you can get a shaker, whatever. I just got an old pesto tin that I have laying around. And that's going to be basically our vinaigrette right there. Delicious. I'm going to give it a quick little taste, make sure it's all good. Yep, that is tasty. All right, so our bacon looks pretty done here. Rendered down quite nicely. The pieces are a little firm. They've got a nice little bit of fat left on them here. That's good stuff. There's the fat tin. All right, so we're just gonna get a little bowl and a little bit of paper towel here, just so we can soak up some of that fat from the bacon as we take it off. So while it is delicious, it will also kill you. Just bacon fast, not exactly the peak of healthiness. There we go. Ow! That's what happens when your bacon fat spits at you. There we go. Wonderful. That little press, and we'll just put that bacon off to the side. Slap that there. We'll dump our hot grease here, and we'll throw it Something to put it into. Don't really have a spare tin. I think it's just gonna melt through this little plastic thing, but we'll see. That stood up pretty decently. Good little plastic jar. All right, so our pan kind of sucks. I wish I could do something with all that flavor that's locked in there, but I don't really have anything. So I'm gonna put it back on the heat. We're gonna just gonna kind of do a quick little deglaze on our pan. You could use some, if you're gonna actually use this, I would recommend you know, a little bit of white wine, a little bit of red wine, maybe a swirl of your beer, but we're not gonna be using it. So deglazing, pretty simple. You throw a little bit of a liquid on there. On a hot pan, and it just lifts everything right off the pan. Like, you get a spoon in there, you kind of just go at it. Boom, look at that. I mean, you could reduce this down if you really wanted, but I got no use for it, like I said. Instead, we'll let it kind of cool a touch. Toss it into our discard cup, and we'll give our pot a wash. Because it's way easier to wash this thing if it's hot than it will be once it cools down and everything kind of gets into all the little crevices. And that's done. Boom, clean pot. Nice. Ah, so our bacon's kind of just going along. It's nice and crisp. Oh yeah. Ooh, that's gonna be good. Oh, perfect. Throw that back up, don't need that. All right. So we got our vinaigrette going here. That's done, it's kind of mixing and melding, get a little better. The couple of minutes that we'll give it. There we go, cleaned off our juicer. Unplug it, we'll put that sucker away. Oh, excuse me. All right. So if we got anyone watching, I hope you're having a good night. I definitely am. Got a couple of beers in me. Got my new capture card, so hopefully this one will work. I've got, I picked up a ripsaw, a razor ripsaw, secondhand, but it said it was brand new in box. I imagine something must have happened to it and I got ripped off, but either way, I ended up biting the bullet, picking up a an Elgato one, which I probably should have bought first. So hopefully tonight, or based on timing on this, I'll be able to eat, maybe set it up and see if it works. Hopefully it's not something with my computer. And hopefully we'll have some Breath of the Wild later on or tomorrow night. Good stuff. All right, so let's get our stuff away, clean up our workstation, because we're going to have to, in a few minutes here, about 10 minutes, we are going to need to be letting these beets come, take them out, and then let them cool down a little bit so that they're not too hot to handle. And then we're going to trim the skin off, which will come off really easy because it's been basically steamed and roasted. I can start to smell them. They are delicious. All right, where's the lid? There's our lid. There we go. Get that off my hands. There we go. All right. Let me see here. All right, so I got my pan. I'm just gonna pop that away. We got our feta ready. So we're gonna want to basically not like. You could crumble your feta, or you could. I'm gonna move this back so you guys can see me on the cutting board.
That was close. Errant cords flying around, you know. Very professional. Very, very professional here.
So we're going to basically. We're just going to chop our feta up, but we're going to try and make it look a little nice, you know? Get this over here. There we go.
Okay. So I've got a Macedonian feta. Now, there's a couple of different styles of feta. You have your classic Greek feta. That's the one that tends to be a little firmer. There's a little bit less moisture content in it. The Macedonian one tends to have a little bit more of almost like a softened goat, softened cheese bit to it. You'll be able to see that here in a sec when I start to chop it. It also has a lot less crumbliness. So it's soft, but it's kind of firm, I guess. It's one of my favorites because it essentially melts in your mouth when you eat it, and it'll go great with this beet salad. So we'll get some nice little cubes of it. Slice down. Try and make some nice little ones. There we go. Well, then it just breaks up like that, you know? Such is life. There we go. And we'll slice and slice. There we go. Put that off to the corner. Now, as you can see, it's really soft. It's almost like an unripened goat cheese. A regular feta would be a lot denser than this. As well, it would be... It just would crumble more and hold together. It's more curd-like, whereas this one is an unripened. It's delicious, though. Mm. So you basically work with it best you can. But with our beet salad, it's a little softer. It's almost like a blue cheese-style texture to it. It's going to be good. There we go. Get that up there. Oh, so soft. I'm just going to crumble it up. The knife is really not doing anything. There we go. Just like that. Now, I mean, I can't let that go to waste. So I'm going to lick my fingers because it's freaking delicious. Oh, sweet. Thanks for the auto host, Rel Norm. Oh, man. Delicious. So again, I hope you guys are having a good night. These beets are smelling amazing. So they've been in there for about 30 minutes now. So I'm going to take a knife. And I'm going to test them out. Oh, they smell divine. Just going to unravel this a little bit here. Let's angle the camera down a bit so you can see. They're definitely going to need a little bit longer. They still are a little hard in the center. Ooh, there we go. Get these suckers back in. Probably going to take about 45 minutes. And we'll ramp the temperature up a little bit just to speed things up. There we go. All right. Slap that up there. Beautiful. Let
see what we got here. Oh, we got Joey sticking out, man. How you doing, Joey?
All right. Oh, this betta is just so good. I mean, look at that.
All right. Get that cleaned up. Super duper easy.
There we go. All right. Now, I also had someone drop off a bunch of apples, so... I think we'll also introduce a little bit of a crunch of an apple. So we got our feta here.
Well, you can say that they're from my family's farm.
Yeah, they're from my fiance's family farm. These are amazing organic gala apples grown in the Okanagan of BC. They are fantastic. I get tons of them free every year. And I probably get sick. I would probably get sick of these apples if they weren't as ridiculously sweet as they are. So we'll kind of just give her a slice up. I'm thinking we'll just kind of give it some. We'll just kind of go with some thinner slices here. Almost as if I was to take it to a mandolin. But I don't have a mandolin. I also hate mandolins. They scare the living shit out of me. There we go. No one wants that crap in there. I think that'll be good. Then I'll just cut this rest one up, and that'll be a little snack.
Here.
Good stuff. Mm. Another whole chunk. Well, these beets are cooking away. I think they're just about done. We'll kind of let that timer run out. I'd rather them be a little softer than not. We'll get some kale. Don't want that to melt. There we go. Alright. Let's kind of throw some into a bowl here. Hey, sissy pity. You know... It does sound fancy, but really, I mean, if you think of it, like, beets are pretty cheap. I got three massive beets for like $4, organic ones at the store. So, I mean, I don't know, I don't think I'm too fancy, but I guess, you know what, when you put it that way, it is kind of a fancy dinner. How's your night going along anyway? Get some nice pieces of kale here. Give her a quick wash in a minute, because truthfully, when it comes to mixed greens, especially in these little tins, you really don't want to risk not washing it. It says triple wash, quadruple wash, trimmed, all that crap, but you never really know what's going to happen. Yeah. Almonds are definitely not cheap. Awesome. Well, welcome to the stream. cheers to you.
Boom.
Thanks for coming by. Ah. We've got a pretty decent menu here, I think. I mean, roasted beet salad is delicious. We're going to throw some... I also... we've added some apple to it. I had some apples dropped off yesterday. And so we're going to slice some apples. They're local apples. Hey, thank you so much for the follow, Sissy Pity. Ugh, keep saying it wrong. Sissy Pity, thank you so much. All right, so we're going to give our kale a quick little rinse here. There we go. Easy peasy. All right. Yum. Put that out to the side. Put some stuff away we don't really need. All right, I'll just call you Sissy then. All right, so we'll put that up for some recycle. There we go. Delicious, delicious. So, we got our vinaigrette here. This is pretty simple. Blood orange, we juiced it. Equal parts, olive oil to vinegar, a little bit of salt, a little bit of pepper, a little bit of balsamic vinegar just for depth of flavor. Throw into a jar is the easiest. I mean, you can get some of those fancy dressing mixer bowls and all that. That's your own choice. We've also toasted up some almonds here. We're going to mix in with this salad. We got those there. We also have our bacon, which is delicious. So we rendered this bacon down. So instead of just throwing this bacon into a pan and letting it go, instead of just rendering it down and letting it, cook, we add, you slice it up. I mean, you can have it any way you want, but just have the pan not be overcrowded. Once the bacon starts to cook, you add a little bit of cold water to the bottom of the pan so that it kind of just about covers the bacon. And it helps retain some of the fat, but also allows the bacon to get a little crispier and render it down. So we did that. And we got our beets in the oven right now. They got about 5 minutes left. Give our knives a quick clean up. Don't want anything sitting around, especially anything acidic. Your knife's worst enemy are not going dull. It's cutting through as acidic food. So tomatoes, apples, berries, anything with a high sugar content. After you've cut those, basically it's like your teeth. Treat them like your teeth. You want to clean them pretty soon after you do anything bad for them. So like I said, cutting through acidic foods, that will eat away at the sharpness of your blade. It'll eat the tips as well. It'll eat away if you have stainless steel stuff. It'll start to leave those little spots. You haven't done a savory stream yet. I usually just bake and decorate sweets. It's funny. So, I mean, I generally will throw a dessert in or something like that. I just don't have time to do that tonight. The stream starting a little bit later than usual. But you can check out my videos and my VODs, I guess, in the very top of the up over there. I've done a lot. The other night we streamed, we did an almond tofu. I think Friday night we're going to do an anan tofu, which is what I was trying to make on Tuesday night, but I got it mixed up and didn't get anan powder, which is apricot kernel powder, which tastes like almonds but isn't almonds. Awesome, thank you. I'm basically just trying to do informative streaming, easy things to cook. I'm not a chef, so I'm basically like, I'm a home cook. I learned from my dad. He told me that if I learn to cook, the ladies will love me. And I'm pretty sure that my lady loves me. All the girls at work, when I bring in leftovers, they fight over trying it. All right, so I'm just going to clean my cutting board here as well. It's been a little while, so I'm going to give a little bit of soap and a rub. And then we'll give it a little bit of an oil down as well once it's dried. Excuse me. You wish your husband would cook. I wish my fiance would cook, but I think we would die if she cooked. She's cooked for me a couple of times. One time, she got these beautiful this beautiful rack of lamb, and she's gonna make it was a yellowish curry. With citrusy curry, and she did almost everything correct to the recipe. It was beautiful looking. The lamb was cooked perfectly. She needed very little help. I helped her chop some stuff because she's kind of scared with knives. But we were doing a half recipe, and she forgot to half the lemon juice. So the curry ended up being extremely sour. We still ate it. It was good, but it ended up being extremely sour. And I suffered through it because it was a birthday dinner. But since then, we just don't let her cook. All right. So as I always try, I mean, I've done it myself. Just not on something as fancy as rack of lamb. But so as I was saying, so one thing I always try and get into you guys is taking care of your utensils and your tools. Cutting board is no different. So with a cutting board, especially one, this one's a bamboo cutting board. You want to, when it's dried, you want to, every now and then, you want to add a little bit of oil to your board. If I could be the only one to cook, I am fine as long as someone else does. See, I wish she did the dishes, but she doesn't. She claims she sometimes does, but that sometimes is maybe once a couple months. All right, so that is our timer on our beets. So we're going to pull these beets out. I am going to quickly change cameras here. Please, I'm sorry if I get you sick. Hopefully I don't get you motion sick. We'll pull these beets out. Yeah, okay, good. You can hear her. Oh, yeah. So we wrap these beets in tin foil. And as you can see, it's starting to, the beet juice is starting to come out. This is why I said wrap it in tin foil, keep that top up, and put a liner on. Just because you wrap that in tin foil, let's turn up the beef, or let's turn up the beet. once you wrap it in tin foil, you can, sometimes you'll feel safe with beets. This juice is real, it will stain your hands. So we're going to take one of these out here. This one's probably the biggest. Be careful doing something like this as well. Steam will escape, and that's never good. Steam will burn. So again, we're going to take our knife, which we had over here. And we're just going to test them. We want the knife to go in pretty easily, but we don't want it to be just you drop it and it flies right through. You want a little bit of crunch. But it wants to, you want it to go in relatively clean. So I can definitely feel that these beets are almost done. But I think it's going to probably be about another 10 minutes or so. So we'll get those back in there. There we go. We'll set our timer for 10 minutes. And I think at that point, they should be good. All right, so I'll repeat what I was saying here. So with a wood cutting board, one big thing is to treat it well. You wanna add a little bit of a vegetable oil to it every now and then.
What happens is the vegetable oil will seep into the little crevices of the wood and the wood grain, and it will kind of help build a natural anti-moisture and antibacterial protection for the board. So if you've ever had a cutting board that's warped or it's split, that's because moisture has gotten in, gotten down into the center of the board and caused it to expand. And because these are pressed together with and usually glued, unless you got a solid piece, which are expensive, it'll pop that glue off, and then you got a rack cutting board, and that's no fun. All right, so I like to use a little bit of avocado oil. It really doesn't impart any flavors, which is nice. So you just want a little drop, a couple of little drops on there. Oh, that's a little more than I wanted, but oh well. I'm gonna do the beets on the plastic cutting board here. I don't mind the plastic one getting stained. The wood one, I'm definitely not gonna use for that because it will stain the crap out of my board. So I'm just gonna rub this avocado oil all over the board. Similar to how you would treat your cast iron cookware, especially your cast iron frying pans. Just get that all over. There we go. Get rid of that. And then just let that dry off somewhere. It'll absorb it and help protect it. Yeah, essentially you don't want to use it for anything too wet. I kind of use mine mainly for vegetables. I don't want to cook any meats or anything like that on there. Don't want to get any of that bacteria, you know, potential salmonella or something like that in there. I use my plastic one for that. I gotta end up getting around to getting a bigger plastic one because that one's kind of tiny. All right, so you got this here. I'm just gonna transfer this over. We'll slap it on a plate here. There we go. Get one of our knives. There we go. Macedonian feta is so good. All right, give this a quick rinse. So something you could do if you only have, I'm gonna have to check out IKEA. I keep meaning to go down. I have very little counter space, so I've noticed they have some really cool kitchen islands, like movable ones. They're on wheels on one end and you can kind of lift them up and kitchen cart, I guess. Picking up one of those, because I've got some spots I could park it when not in use. I just don't have any. I am in Canada. Are you also a fellow Canadian? You might be able to tell when I say a boat or a car, bar, bagel. A lot of people get that. I'm not in the East Coast, but I'm from the East Coast. All right, put that away here. Got about 5 minutes left on our beets. Take another sip of some beer. You're basically a Canadian. Hey, Canada's great. I mean, hey, I'm born and raised in Canada, so I've been, I've been down the border a little bit, but with the crap Canadian dollar most of my life, it's few and far between. Ah, you're in Georgia. Nice. I've had a few friends from Georgia. They're pretty cool people. They got a little too hardcore in some raiding, though, in the old World of Warcraft. They got a little crazy about that. I'm going to grab a piece of bacon. Yeah. I mean, I'm not a big fan of politics, but I'll take Trudeau over Trump any day. I'll definitely say that. It's a little more level-headed, maybe, I guess. All right, I can't wait for this. So we got toasted almonds, we got our bacon, we got our feta, we got some apple, we got some kale sitting over here. I think that's everything we got. Let me take a look here. Boom, boom. We got kale, feta, bacon, toasted almonds. Our beets are roasting away. Blood orange vinaigrette. We're doing good here, I think. There we go. Kill that. I just want to open that up. Oh, I see. Yeah, there's a kitty. We got two little kitties. Move him a little closer. Forward up. There you go. He's kind of curious. He's never really been in that area before. Beets will take anywhere from 45 minutes to an hour to roast. Kind of depends on their size. These ones are relatively large beets, so they're going to take a little bit longer. Let's see. Where did the camera go? That's a shot of him. She can hear him purr. He's a loud purr, that's for sure. Look at his big old claws. This sucker, he's like 14 pounds.
Yeah,
he's a heavy boy. Yeah. He is a big boy. Yeah. Yeah, he's we got him as a rescue. He's grown quite a lot.
They both have.
Yeah, I think when we got him, he was 8 pounds, but yeah, now he's 14. He's not excessively fat. Oh, nice. Yeah, we have a brother and a sister. They were found stray in at like a few months old down in a big field, and the local kitten rescue society, they picked them up, and we went and looked at them. We were like, these guys are adorable. We'll take them. Ah. Well, you know what? I mean, some small kitties are also pretty fun, especially we have a bit of a smaller space. So, oh, nice. Taco and noodle. Oh, that's good. I'll show you this here. There we go. They're named Busta and Missy. You can probably figure out where that's from. And yeah, they're supposed to be brother and sister. They're cute little kitties. I'll go see if I can find Missy. One sec. Since we got a few minutes to kill. You got her?
On my chair.
We're gonna have to disturb her. We gotta pay our internet kitty tax. This one you'll definitely be able to hear purr. There we go. She's like, what's going on? I don't usually get to see the oven. Yeah. She's got the really nice kind of mane on her. Right on the front, that sold it. Aw, baby. Here, I'll let you down. The internet kitty tax has been paid. All right. Beets are about to come out. There we go. Oh, yeah. We're pretty sure they're part, what's it called? Bobcat wire freaking thing. I can usually get it. Maine Coon. We're pretty sure they're part Maine Coon. The bigger guy, for sure. Not sure. Oh, stupid. The word coon stops the stupid auto mod. Oh, man. Yeah, Maine Coon. We're pretty sure they're part Maine Coon. Because they have fluffy tails. Like, their tails are massive. Yeah, no, the auto mod definitely didn't like that. I mean, it's just part of the whole thing, you know. Want to make sure everyone's welcome in the channel. Don't want anything, you know, offensive being thrown around. All right, let's check these beats because I'm pretty sure these are done. Whew, steamy. Oh, yeah. Yeah, exactly. It definitely explains their size. Those kitties are large. Whew. Yep. Done. Should probably have brought some gloves home. Oh, yeah. That one's good. All right. Well, let these cool down. We're going to need to let these cool down for at least probably 5 minutes minimum. I don't want to burn my hands. So we're going to, look at the juice on some of these, eh? That is going to stain. Well, that's why I left my work jeans on. Oh, yeah. All right. There we go. We'll use those. Perfect. All right. So we'll let these cool down. So I left the skin on while they bake just to kind of help bring any nutrients and trap a little bit of moisture in there, hopefully. So we'll just give them a quick, it'll be super easy to chop the skin off. Then we'll give it a quick dice. Let it cool just a little bit. We'll add in our feta so it melts just a touch. Add in our kale so it wilts a little bit. Toss in our bacon, toss in our almonds on top. Oh, this is going to be delicious. And then, of course, we can't forget, got to use up our blood orange vinaigrette, which we will actually kind of toss with the beets first. So it kind of has a chance to absorb into the beets a little bit. Kind of adds a nice sweet tartness to the beets. Where did my tongs go? There they are. All right. Look at that. That is nice. All right. Before my hands get too messy, because I forgot to buy gloves, I'm going to move this over to the cutting board so you guys can see. There we go. All right. All right, no worries. So we're just going to trim the edges here, get the skin off these beets. No one wants to eat that. Beautiful. Throw that there. Dump our excess water from the bottle here. All right. So what we're going to do is we'll get the skin off these beets. And then we'll give it a quick little chop. We want bite-sized pieces. There we go. Perfect. Try and get consistent sizes as best we can.
you know, just for presentation's work, sense. So we'll throw these super warm, delicious beets. We're gonna toss these into a bowl. And once we get them all in there, I'm gonna quickly just kind of toss them with a little bit of the dressing. Get our next one here. Go. Beautiful. As you can see, I'm also using my tongs to hold this around. Makes it a little more difficult, but it's also going to save my hands from being bloody red and having to explain to the officer as he pulls me over, "No, officer, I have not committed any murder. I just cooked with beets last night." There we go. Again, try and get consistent sizes if you can. It's just really nice for presentations. I'm not really having to impress anybody, but if you have to impress someone coming over, then there you go. Hey, yeah. A little bit of a late dinner tonight. What was that? That was a weird... Did you... Oh! Middleist, thank you for the follow. It didn't even pop up as a chat message. I got the email and I got the alert, but I didn't get the chat message. But yeah, didn't get home till probably 7:30. But so I've been going for the last hour and 15 minutes. So again, just trimming the skin off these beets. They are soft and delicious. There we go. Get that off. And we'll try and get some nice consistent sizing. There we go. Beautiful. And we got two more to go. Ah, this is one of the ones that was massive. This was just half the beet. It was ridiculous. All right. Get off that. Actually, you know, probably be a little easier with the paring knife. A little more control. A little easier to do the finesse, as they would say. I ended up picking up an Elgato, the PCIe capture card. Got that same day shipped to work. Was awesome. So I'm going to hook that up after I'm done making all this. And hopefully I'll be able to stream a little bit of Breath of the Wild. As well as some Battlefield with co-workers and such. And be able to kind of increase the stream quality of right from the consoles. Oh, Yes.
So how was your day, Middleist?
You just getting home from work or what? Because you've been... This is pretty late for you. I think you're going... You're heading off to Japan soon too, aren't you? Go. Nice. Are you going into work tomorrow, or do you guys leave tomorrow, or do you leave later on? There we go. The last one. Perfect.
The 2-day training session start today at work. Unexpected. Oh, man. Had to work OT to catch up on normal work because of that, obviously. You know, good old government stuff. Work tomorrow. Oh, you guys leave Saturday morning. Oh.
Hey, welcome back, sissy. We just finished chopping up all our beets, so you missed all the boring stuff. Give our poor knife a clean. Don't really need that anymore. Same with our tongs. Although I'll probably use those to toss that. And then our poor, poor cutting board. This is going to be a warm salad, yes. Yeah, it is a bloody mess. There we go. That'll go into the compost tonight. All right, so this is what it starts as. Let's see what it's going to finish as. A little bit of soap on there. You know, that's not too bad. It's a little brown or a little red still, but I think that's acceptable. So yeah, this is going to be a warm salad, so the beets are going to be warm. So that's going to kind of wilt the kale a little bit. It'll help melt a little bit of the feta. The apple will get a little warm. And then the almonds and bacon will be kind of like room temperature, so they add a bit of a crunch as well. Ha, if only I had a dishwasher. These two hands are the dishwasher. All right, so we got our vinegar out here. I'm gonna pour about half of this onto the beets. There we go. I'm gonna toss these beets. This is basically just gonna kind of, the vinegar in there is gonna help kind of get into the beets. It's gonna add a little more flavor to the beets. And in general, it's just going to absorb in to the beets and make them just delicious. All right. I'm going to give one of these suckers a try. Not too hot, still warm. Oh, yeah. Yep. Sweet. They've lost almost all of the earthiness you get from a root vegetable. The vinegar adds a nice little kind of kick through it. All right. So I think at this time, I'm just going to clean this this aluminum foil up, and then we're going to get on to plating, I think, because it is time. There we go. Again, if you ever have questions about any of the recipes and stuff I'm doing, on my Discord channel, that Botamus Prime links every now and then, at the end of the stream, I go on there and I type up all the recipes that I did with instructions, so you guys can hopefully kind of try it at home, or maybe give me some tips if you see that. And that'll, you know, you can hang out and talk to me outside of the stream if you want. As well, it just kind of lets you know. I always give a heads up in the Discord channel when I'm going live. It's a little more up to date than the schedule I have at the bottom. I do have a Twitter. I'll send a link here. Pretty much same username as I have on here. Anytime I update the channel, which is when it'll send a Twitter a tweet out as well. I also try and post a little bit to the social media. Apparently that helps if you are trying to be a Twitch partner. So it's good to get that in early in case I ever get to that point. Okay, so I think it is time for some plating. So I'm going to get rid of this. I'm going to turn my oven off because I don't know why I didn't already. You know, that is actually a good command. I think I'm going to take that and do a exclamation mark Twitter command. Or maybe like social media or something like that. And it'll have Botamus Prime link all that up. Okay. Let's rearrange the camera here because I clearly... I'm a low-budget streamer. Only got one camera plus a crappy laptop camera. Let's see here. Right on the stove, too. You know, the nice clean stove. Oh, yeah. All right. So we've got our bacon. We have our toasted almonds. Bacon. Toasted almonds. Let's get rid of that. There we go. That's our stuff that's going on top. Oh, nice. Oh, sweet. Thank you very much. I actually have some. I made the raw, but I think that'll be all right. Tastes good. I think it'll be nice. Oh, yeah. There we go. Good tip. I made Raincoast crisps the other night. And I did pumpkin seeds, almond, flax seed, and rosemary. They were really good. All right. Couple of bowls. Let's see. Let me do this. There we go. Okay. So I'm going to take the kale and I'm just going to kind of toss that into the beets. So we got our beets here and they're still a little warm. So I'm just going to toss it in there. It'll wilt it ever so slightly, but it'll also just kind of mix in a little bit of that vinaigrette to start. And it's just going to add a really nice splash of color because we're going to have red, we're going to have brown on the bacon.
gonna have a little bit of white with the apple and the feta. So the green will be it'll be a nice addition to it. So we're just gonna put some of this, put some of our warm beets right on the bottom here. Oh, you know, the coloring on these beets looks so nice on OBS. Like, it's actually really beautiful color contrast. In person, under some light, they're a very, like, crimson color. Ah, there's the follows. Thank you so much. I'm going to have to make that a bit bigger because it seems like the alert on the top for people with a bit longer names, they doesn't tend to show up very well. It shows the whole name, but it doesn't say what happened. Yeah, I think it's a color balance issue you can go in and do. You can go into the properties of OBS and do different colors because it kind of looks a little washed out. I just haven't gotten around to doing that. Mainly because usually when I use, especially this camera here, it's the Logitech C922X. I usually have it as just like a face cam for when I'm playing video games is what I initially got it for. And now it's kind of turned into the best quality one I have. Yeah, that's generally what I do is I take pictures and post it on Discord. And a link, or I'll put it on Twitter and stuff. And my family likes it when I put it on Facebook. All right, there we go. So we got our beets. Looks really nice. We'll put some almonds on top. Just kind of toss them on there. We'll add a nice crunch, a nice little color contrast. There we go. And then we'll put on some of those raw pumpkin seeds we had. Makes a nice healthy dinner too. You know, we got lots of seeds for some protein in there. We got also some nice healthy fats as well. Then I think we'll take some apple slices. Just kind of, you know, put them along the side here. Kind of centers the beet. There we go. He looks pretty good, I think. All right, now we'll take our bacon. Sprinkle that on top, because bacon is delicious. Well, I think she got all the bacon. I'm gonna steal a couple pieces for mine. All right, now for my favorite. Now we're gonna put all this delicious feta cheese on top. Oh man, look at this. I know, right? This looks amazing. This is probably the prettiest dish I've ever made. Aside from cookies. Cookies, it doesn't matter what they look like. They're pretty. There we go. Easy. Okay. All right. That is dinner, man. Look at this. I'll get a little closer in here. That is not too bad. Oh, there we go. All right. Now's the best time. Now it's taste test time. So I'm gonna take this nice pretty one. I'm gonna replace it with the one that I'm gonna be eating. I'm gonna bring the nice pretty one to my lady. But not before I take a picture. I gotta take a picture first. Gotta whip out the old camera. Gotta get the good angles, right? There we go. All right. Go give this to the lady, and then I'll be right back. There we go. Food of Instagram. it's not the HEFA filter. You gotta put the sepia filter. Always the sepia filter. All right, peoples. Taste test time. I mean, I'm not gonna say it tastes bad, obviously. Ooh. Cheers. Mmm. Sweet beets, salty fatty bacon, salty feta. Mmm. The apples on the side. There you go. Exactly. Valencia. Oh, yeah. This is pretty killer. I like the call. I appreciate the call with the pumpkin seeds. They add a nice crunch. Really nice crunch. That is good stuff. Oh, yeah. Well, she's currently in a dungeon. She didn't even look at it, as usual. Yep. That is good. Maybe not the best beer. I wouldn't recommend an English-style brown ale with this. I know, right? Not as appreciative. She's really appreciative when we go to a restaurant and it looks nice. But when we're at home, it's video game time. I bet nice summer day. Get a nice tart. Like a sour beer or maybe a nice light Hefeweizen or a glass of white wine or just like a nice light cocktail would be amazing brunch with this. Because it's not too heavy. Nice little crunch. Good start to the day. How can you go wrong with a little bacon, feta cheese, beets, apple? Good stuff. I mean, hey, I don't take like 6 hours to cook something. Oh, yeah, that is killer. The bacon really makes it. Like, it's just the sweet, fatty salt that it adds. Really nice. Yeah. I'm curious, is it? Ooh, the bridge blood orange would be good. Ha! Eh, I got time. Let's see how well it goes. I mean, come on, man. I work right near these guys. Yeah, exactly. Oh, yeah. No, that is a good combo. Much lighter. I have my only problem. I love their beer, but I went there to get a growler fill. I was like a Saturday or Sunday. It's like noon. I go in and I go, "Hey, I want to get my growler filled." And the lady at the thing goes, "Oh, sorry, they're brewing right now. We don't do growler fills while they're brewing beer." Your husband would never eat this. Even with bacon? There's bacon. All you have to do is tell the most vegetable-hating person in the world that you have bacon in there, and they'll eat it. Anything is better with bacon. I know, right? So, I ended up going back to Bridge. He would eat the bacon feta and apples. Okay. The first time I did roasted beets, I never thought I'd like them, but I figured, whatever, I got a bunch I need to cook anyway. As long as they try them, it's amazing. Like, you can't go wrong. Cooked beets is like, they're sweet. They're amazing. Making a mess. Yeah. Well, see, people who think they taste like dirt have probably only had boiled beets, which are still really good. Or maybe they just had terrible beets. Yeah. Just laugh at them when they don't eat it. God damn. Right? Ooh, borscht. Borscht is good. See, that's all you gotta do is have a willing palate to try anything. If you're willing to try anything once, I don't care if you hate it afterwards. You hate it before, you try it once, then you still don't like it. You know what? That's cool. You tried it. You have the balls to try that and at least confirm that you didn't like it. Well, I mean, cabbage is basically like, cabbage is really good too. Like, yeah. Oh, there we go. It's a little easier. A little floating head. If you will try something and then tell me you don't like it, I'll accept that. If you won't try something and tell me that you don't like it, I don't accept that. Okay, this is weird to eat. I gotta stand up. Ma'am, good freaking stuff. Ah. So what time do you usually do your stream? Oh, well, okay. There are some exceptions to the rules.
And the exceptions to those rules are things that are kind of messed up, like Balut. One thing I'd like to try. Okay. I mean, people think durian's delicious too, and I don't understand it. I tried it, didn't like it. Maybe it was bad durian, but nice. Okay. The smell and taste are kind of overrated. It's not as horrible as people say, but it's also not as good as people say. Yeah, I mean, the thing with Balut is it just looks gross, and that's half the battle, is getting over the look. Yeah, see, I had someone in here the other day, Fadoodle, I think his name was, and he was telling me about jackfruit and how you can use it as a substitute for chicken. So I think I'm going to see if I can find a big enough, like, not canned jackfruit and look about doing, like, a slow roasted jackfruit show. Because I think that'd be pretty sweet. Like, I'm really... Well, I'm in Vancouver, sissy. So there's a really large Asian population. So I don't think I would have a hard time finding it fresh. I might just have to drive a bit of a distance down to Richmond or something like that, where it's a heavily... like Chinese population, to be able to find it fresh. But you can find just about anything in the greater Vancouver area. I mean, there's definitely some culture and stuff in that in Georgia, but I mean, as I was saying earlier, I have friends in Georgia who are really great. It's not unfortunate, but they are, they're gay, and they say they have a really hard time there because of the way that people aren't as accepting of as different things in Georgia. Luckily they're moving away sometime soon, so hopefully they'll be able to live a better lifestyle. But yeah, here in Vancouver, it's pretty easy to find anything Asian, because it's like, I think at this point, I'm probably a minority. Like, definitely not the majority. Which is unfortunate, but I mean, everyone's entitled to their free speech as long as they don't hurt others. Unfortunately, sometimes that's what happens, and that sucks. I gotta say, roasted beets, they're cheap, they're delicious. I recommend it. I've made a similar salad before, but this is just killer. It's great. So, I think so. Like, so let me see if I can pick this up. So just watch it break. Right? So you see that it kind of bends a little bit, and then it just gave right away. It's perfect. It's soft, but it still has a little bit of a crunch. So it's kind of like, it's not just melting away in my mouth. It's actually kind of crumbling. Yeah. I wouldn't call it chewy, but it's soft but firm. I don't know how to describe it, but it's the perfect texture because it goes so well with the soft cheese and especially those pumpkin seeds you recommended. That's killer in here. The almonds. When you get a little bit of everything, it's like a flavor explosion in your mouth. The feta opens up everything else. The bacon adds a nice little salty fatness. It is great. Yeah. I'm actually okay. Ever since I started streaming, it's kind of cool because I'm starting to kind of cook smaller. I usually cook big meals and have like leftovers for like 4 or 5 days and just eat them at lunch at work. But ever since I started streaming, I've kind of opened up what I'm willing to do a little more, which is really neat because I'll be able to kind of expand, and I'm looking in the aisle, seeing if I can find something like new to me so I can try it out on stream. Because the more odd something sounds, I think the more likely someone is to pull in and kind of just check out what's going on. And that's great. Because what I'm trying to do here is kind of try and teach people a little bit as I go so that people come in and they learn a little bit about cooking and find out that, like, you don't have to be a chef to be a good cook. A little bit of home cooking, a little bit of research online ahead of time. Anyone can be a great cook. And not a good chef just knows how to do it a lot faster and more consistent and look nicer. Awesome. Well, I'm going to give you a reciprocating follow next time you're online. Nice. Yeah. I have no culinary training. I watch a lot of YouTube videos, a lot of Food Network in my time. Nice. I think you'll have a good time. I try and do a little bit of both, you know, throwing some video games in the middle. But I think the biggest thing for me is I like to interact with the viewers and kind of like chat with you guys and just be like, yo, how's your day? What do you think? You know, let's just chat, and I'm going to cook and hopefully you'll enjoy it. And maybe you'll jump in like Discord or Twitter or whatever. And I like it. I'd love it if some people gave me some suggestions they'd like to see stream. Because that way it's something that might take me out of my comfort zone, which is kind of cool. Love watching Suck at Playing. That was good. Yeah, that is definitely exactly what Twitch is all about, right? Like, people ask me, like, because, you know, people at work and stuff like that have found out that I'm doing this and all that, and it's great because someone will chime in, like, someone have been watching videos. I should do Rack of Lamb. Maybe I'll, I'm trying to, like, plan my shows ahead as much as I can so I don't have to, like, rush out and buy everything the day of. I'd rather be able to buy it a day ahead or in advance or something like that so I can just kind of roll in at home. It can be expensive. It is. So I think I'd probably do something like that as like a special day thing. I don't have any birthdays or anything like that coming up, but Valentine's Day just passed, so who knows? Yeah. Well, I mean, like, for me, I could do, you know, I could do cookies any day, you know, a quick bread any day, anything like that, but I don't have a lot of like shelf space, so I don't, I have to usually buy pretty quick. Oh, Middleist. Your tales of the kitchen will never surprise me. I know, baking's pretty easy because the main things you need to have on you is like flour, sugar, and some stuff to throw in the flour and sugar. This is good. Butter, that's it. I mean, who doesn't have flour, sugar, butter all the time, right? Cream cheese is good. Talking about cream cheese, okay. I think we're gonna do a buddy a favor here. Because I'm about done for the night, but what I'm gonna do is there's a guy that's been doing this a little bit longer than me. He's been going about 5-6 months that has helped me out a lot. So I'm gonna go do a quick little host here of him, and hopefully you'll check his stream out. I think he's still going. I'm gonna go double check, but he's actually doing cheesecake right now. So one sec. Yeah, no worries. Let me just get one sec. She did eat it.